This is my banker's update. I sent the insurance company an email because that was one of the checks that I one of the private checks that I wrote. And it was the one for $283 that I sent to the insurance company, which my plan carried out was to go to the DMV and order military plates for my car. So the bank returned those two checks. So the insurance company sent me an email, the insurance representative for the insurance company, which is the local office here down at the corner. And he sent me an email and said the check was returned, and there's a $10 charge for that. And I just, out of the sake of keeping the peace in the community, peace and the safety, I answered his email truthfully. And that's all you gotta do. You just operate in the truth, and there's really no sidestepping that has to be done. But it is nice to be general in our terms, in which the recipients can at least get the intention of our hearts and the words that we use. And we put our intentions on those words also. But so the email that I sent him was that there is a, I have opened up a private lawful investigation into the matter, and that check will be honored. And I'll keep him updated on the latest info on it, on the case. So that's all you gotta do. Because you don't have to hammer the nail with one blow in situations like that. You can just tap on it. And just as it is when you're building a house, you always tap your hammer on your nail however you like. That's the best way to have anything in life done for you, is to be able to do it whenever you want and do it in your way that's comfortable with your system and your body. It's your own rhythm that you create for yourself, which you have rightful rulership over. As long as you're keeping peace, as long as your intentions and your heart and your thoughts and your heart towards everybody else is peaceful and is safe and is encouraging and uplifting, and to the point that you struggle with that within your own mind, that is the mirror that Mother Nature is going to hold up to you so that you see yourself. So everywhere you go, if you hold bitter envy in your heart towards anybody, then Mother Nature is going to see to it that bitter envious people do the same thing to you in your daily life, all the way from your privacy in your shower, all the way to public appearances walking out in the town or at your public job. It'll all be reflected right back to you. And so my point is not to leave you on a sour note, but to leave you in a state of balance so that you can see both sides of the world and how they operate. Because that is both sides of the fence. that's the sad face and the happy face posted on these t-shirts that everybody wears going through town. It's male-female energy. And the female energy is always the impulsive, instinctive, fight-first energy. And the male energy is the sit back and relax and think it through first energy. So it's a balance of the two that we're seeking, because we are both impulsive and we are both thoughtful. When we rise up to pick up our guitar and all of a sudden just strum some notes out thin air, for the most part, that's impulsive. And it's a happy thing. We're just looking to learn to tame our impulses. And that's the female side of the lower brain called the cerebellum. So, but you got me started preaching, so. I was motivated by your presence, let's put it that way. I was motivated by your real life presence. And there is a difference between speaking live and speaking in the manufactured realm of the internet. There is a difference in power, and a difference in the release of energy, and the release of the words, and the intention of the words that go out into the atmosphere to everybody around, you know, around the vicinity. It's, if you have loving intentions, then that love and that light will radiate throughout your area. So, it is interesting that as soon as I sent that investigative letter in the mail to the IRS CID, which is Criminal Investigation Department, the governor of Oregon stepped down, and the Secretary of State, who enforces all lien positions, moved one step closer to the cities, because she knows the paperwork that I just put in is very important. So, when you start to see the tree bend, you know the wind's blowing. These are just natural signs that I see in the air and my mother sees. And so we get together and we meet, and we put another piece to the puzzle of how this earth operates together and into the master puzzle. Because we do, together, her and I, do have a master puzzle of what's going on. And how to bring it about, as well as other people too. Now, we're not the only ones that are doing this throughout the earth. We are just the ones that are sitting at the top, who have the brains and the training and the love to funnel out the most principal ideas that the universe wants all together. Because it's not just me, it's not just my mother, it's the collection of the universe. It's all spirits that are in agreement with this. And they are waiting for the manifestation of their bodies again, so they can come back down here and live again in their bodies. And that's the important key that I'm here on this earth to accomplish. So, but all that collective soul, some people call it collective soul, all them collective spirits have one agreed upon agenda, and that is the rehabilitation of all people, all creation that needs healing in their lives. And it's a gentle rehabilitation. It's a here, walk this way with an outstretched hand saying, you know, these are the things that need to be brought into consciousness, into the forefront of our minds together, as one. And if any of us has been left behind, then it's incumbent upon us to go and care for those that are still in the growing process. And there's nothing wrong with being in the growing process at any point in time where we are at, because everybody has to go through it. Everybody reaches their growing processes at their own time and their own way. And that is the main agreement of all the collective spirits throughout the whole universe. And to train everybody that if that's so, then you now have the universal inherited right to be your own self, your own character, without anybody setting any rules for you. As long as you do it in a safe and peaceful way. And I'll leave that safe and peaceful way to your own conscience, because ultimately you are your own law. And so you have to be the one to deal with yourself of when you think that you've stepped over the boundary, and when you know for sure that you are being peaceful. And you'll hear an old saying in private maritime law. When you hear Winston Shrout teach on his videos, he'll say this over and over again. I just had it on the tip of my tongue, so I'll just let it arrive when it needs to. But you pretty much get the gist of where I was getting at. Because it's my intentions that I put into the air is that it carries the day. It's not my words. So if I find myself tripping and struggling on my words, all because I'm feeling attached to get my point across, then I just use that tripping over my words as a contrast to say, okay, I don't want that to happen no more, so how about I just desire not being able to trip over my words and desire being in rest, desire being calm and peaceful. And so when I get unattached, I start paying attention to my body. Because when I get attached, my body sends a pain signal. And so I have to say to myself, okay, let me take care of this pain. For me, it hits me right in the root chakra. It's like a burning feeling, burning sensation. So that automatically tells me that that's a repressed emotion that needs to be dealt with. And my repressed emotion that's being repressed is this. It's the statement that I'm wanting to make. The statement, the truth that's wanting to rise up in the midst of uncomfortable circumstances. And that is the claymoline that I have. Nothing, no person or nothing can collect from my body anymore. And so I have to constantly remind myself that. If I don't, then all my emotions become that particular truth that wants to rise as the cream of the crop to the top of the cup gets repressed and it's held down. And it's held down by the thought of fear, anger, rage, sadness, and all those other things. So, so becoming unattached is really the main focus when we start feeling pain in the body, like headaches. The body will send pain to the head, to the shoulder, to the back. It'll send it anywhere in the body. And it will make you think that there's something structurally wrong with your body. And you'll actually go to the doctors, and most doctors are trained in Well, actually, it's a minority now. The minority of doctors are trained in structural diagnosis. But the majority of the doctors now that have taken over with the Illuminati coming on the scene, they are proving that it's all psychological. All pain in the body is all psychological. Except for the stuff that you actually do, like tear your ligaments, literally tear your ligaments apart and break your bones. This is all natural pain. But I'm talking about manufactured pain that the brain manufactures, and it will send artificial pain in your body, in our bodies. But as you can see, like I like to do on this, like, see, I got my door open now. I got the front door open. So I have something living that I'm talking, why I'm talking right now. Because it's just like being in the backyard. If you go in the backyard and you talk in your own private backyard, like I've been doing all summer and winter, and calling it my Russell Radio, 88.8 IM, the revelation and the knowledge that gets traded between me and the public, me and the neighbors, me and all creatures, all birds, squirrels, everything, dogs, cats, we all intermingle. We trade sounds together here in the vibrations in the neighborhood where we're at. So, with the front door open, you know, I hear people out there. And so that motivates me to speak. And just like a flock of birds will gather in a tree, they start speaking. They start sharing what they know. You know? And so that's what I naturally do when I'm in my yard, in my house, and I sense that any creatures out there, especially humans, are listening. It becomes a living conversation, and you can tell a difference in my voice, in my character, in my life. You can tell that I'm totally rejuvenated by doing it this way. You can tell a total difference. And the good thing about my when I speak live in nature is that my thoughts just go any direction, and it feels comfortable and normal. And I do a lot of explaining at all the different turns that I take in my conversations also, because I want to have everybody aware. I want to see if they are aware of what I'm saying. I'm wanting to know what kind of effect it has with them. So I have to do a mirror situation. But I want to go back outside. So I just wanted to make this video about that. You know, I didn't just come down on the insurance company and say, "Hey, I got a lien, da 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 da." That wasn't the time to do that, because they weren't coming to take anything from me. You see, there's a difference when they are attempting to come and take, or giving the appearance of coming and taking stuff from you, like sending foreclosure letters in the mail, or the city knocking on a door wanting to condemn the property. At that point, that's when you say, "Hey, here's the lien. Please check with your attorneys." And you do that nicely. But for like this insurance company, they're just wanting payment. Then I just, you know, I didn't have to say, "Well, hey, you have no right to collect, here's my lien," or even just to put it in nice terms, "Well, I have a lien position here, and, you know, technically you can't be sending me these bills, everything's free." You know, I could have gone into it like that, but no, there was no need to. It's I'm taking care of everything at a higher level up the chain of command. And so it's no use dragging other people in. Just let them know that there's a meeting taking place, and I'll keep them updated on what's happening. So, and they understand when I use the word lawful investigation, then they can much put two and two together, especially the owner of the insurance agency. They're kind of well-versed in insurance bonds, which is the main bond being the birth certificate application bond. A lot of them out there understand this. All right.